I'd rather chill alone than try to fit in.
8:01 a.m.
Jesus
Christ. Right when class starts, I tweeted
that. You tweeted that? Yeah. By yourself, leaning on First your locker. Day after leaning on your locker.
Christmas break just ended.
Warning. You're about to embark on an adventure of epic proportions. Buckle up, bucko. You're now tuned in to the Epic Show. With your hosts, Gabe and Dave. Coming to you live from the Epic Center.
Welcome back, guys, to episode 40...
46. 40,
no.
7.
44? 44.
One of those numbers.
One of the... In the 40s.
One of the
range.
Early 40s. Maybe yeah. The mid-40s.
In mid-40s. If you're in your mid-40s watching this, you actually get a free Subway gift card. So.
Yeah, true. That's true.
We can't. No one's.
Ask your local Subway about that.
Yeah, just be like, I don't know if you guys know about the Epic Show, but they said I got a free $5 gift card. I'm actually 45 right now.
Swarm them.
I'm 45.
Actually, it's the 44. Early 40s if you're a woman, but it's the mid-40s if you're a man.
Right, right. So. And if...
Because numbers work differently.
Yeah, every number is different.
Women's age.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So welcome back, guys. We actually... I don't know if you guys have been seeing the new Spider-Verse burger. Gabe's starving right now. He's been...
I'm so hungry.
So I actually picked it up. It's probably lukewarm right now.
It's probably so soiled now.
It's...
Oh, it's freezing.
But there's a... Oh, God. It's actually frigid.
Great.
So that might affect the review, but
okay,
we're gonna try it.
Got a 10 out of 10 on the packaging.
Yeah. So,
but it's some liquids just leaked out on my ankle. So.
Well, yeah, that's part of the deal.
It's a Heinz establishment. That's what it says.
So this is a
Jesus
red burger.
Oh Christ.
So there's like memes going around of like people being like, "All right, man, you like excited to eat the." The new Spider-Verse burger.
What is that?
It's
white stuff. Oh, it's mayonnaise, right?
Oh no! Well, there's a mayonnaise. The
there's a white cheese.
Swiss cheese.
Swiss.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like I don't know. It's like Gwen Stacy.
Why are
like,
there buns on the bottom? I mean, why are there beans on the bottom?
That's the Spider-Verse.
Or sesame seeds.
Sesame seeds. They're black.
They're small beans.
Yeah. Are these the motherboards on there on the top? Or
I think those are the motherboards on this. I think that's on this like device.
So. Yeah, it's red. It's actually beet juice.
It looks. Oh, it's beet juice.
Yeah, that's? It's not red. Apparently, people think it's red 40, which is like toxic.
It's terrible.
But this is like
beet juice. It's
they did a whole campaign about how they don't.
What would you eat? What would you guys eat? This gummy pizza or the Spider-Verse burger?
Would you rather? Which would you rather?
Let me know.
So,
because I'll tell you right now.
I'll tell you. Let me tell you.
Bottoms up.
Hold on. Bon appetit. Down the hatch. Mm-hmm. Could be a little warmer.
Could definitely be warmer. What I don't like about a Whopper is this whole situation.
That's not the best situation.
The fact that it looks like someone could be born out of this 9 months later.
Yeah.
Probably not the most fun thing to eat. But I should have told you no pickles. Because I like pickles.
Oh, they put a lot.
Just not on sandwiches.
Yeah.
I like pickles by themselves, or I make little pickle tacos out of ham and cheese, and then a pickle in the middle.
And then, like, pickled onions.
And then pickled onions and pickled beet juice. Jesus Christ, rather 9 pickles on this. And then, see, if I have to do surgery on the burger.
It's not a burger.
No, if I have to do surgery on a Whopper. I look like I just worked the dirtiest job in America. And I was like cleaning up after a sex scene.
Yeah, and you're like. Well.
Tastes like it too.
I don't know. I mean.
It's good.
It's solid.
I mean, Whoppers are good, so.
I thought the bun was going to taste like something.
It does.
You taste
it? I taste the beet juice.
Are you a Burger? You're really. I feel like
I'm a Burger King guy.
Oh, God. Mm-hmm. What has Burger King done for you recently? That other places can't do.
$2.49, 10 chicken nuggets with all the sauces.
They don't have sauces.
Yeah, they do. And they have a Parmesan, they have a Parmesan chicken sandwich too. Like no one else does that. Dude, you know who used to have a crazy chicken parm sandwich? No. Zaxby's.
Ew.
It was so fire. God. And if you don't know what Zaxby's is, it's like the equivalent to like a Raisin Cane's or like.
You would not know what Zaxby's is?
Zaxby's isn't, Zaxby's is a Southern thing.
What are you rating this guy? Side note, the Impossible Whopper is actually the best thing.
You think that. No one else thinks that though. Actually, no, one of my friends think that. What are you giving it?
6.8 out of 10. Mid. Sorry.
It's not mid. And that rating isn't mid either. It's actually a good rating.
It's like, it's below good though.
It's better than.
7 and up is good.
No. 5 and up is good.
5 is like.
5.5 is up.
Someone gives a 5, I'm like, oh, I'm not going there. Yeah.
Well, I like to be a little bit more in-depth in my reviews. And I think that the Whopper needs a little bit more credit because it saved the fast food industry for a while there.
Okay. It saved it?
It saved it.
In what way?
In the 80s, it needed some saving. And then that's why Marvel gave Burger King the Spider-Man food because it's the savior of the fast food and Spider-Man's the savior of the MCU. Superhero movie?
Yeah.
So,
well, Guardians was.
Similar things.
Privilege, man.
No.
Guardians was the, like, the booster that we.
Marvel's honestly past saving now. I'm going to be honest. Marvel was the end. It was the good end. Yeah.
Passes.
I mean, Guardians was a good end, but I'm giving this a 7.3 out of 10.
Okay. It's not that much different than mine.
It's a little bit. In school, if you got a 68 on something, you failed. And then, yeah. And then if you got a 73 on something, you were lit. Well, I was.
6.8, 7.3. 7.3. I thought it was going to be lethal. Well, I guess we'll have to wait until
the issue with America and the world really is at such a young age we define our worth from the numbers that other people give us. That miserable people most of the time give us.
Okay.
Like grades.
True.
I'm not gonna say the scale because we do give ourselves that number.
Yeah.
But and then it. And then Instagram followers.
Yeah, it's just the numbers.
Twitter followers. Right? It's everything is money. It's number. Like
big numbers.
Bigger numbers, better.
Some have bigger than others. Inches.
Bigger inches.
Yeah, it's all just numbers, really.
Everything, yeah. Your entire worth comes down to how many you have of this or how less you have of that.
That kind of changes the rating to actually... the infinity symbol. So that's the new
rating. Shut up.
All right, guys. So what do you say we get dig deep?
What do you say I open up this bag of peanuts that's next to me and I dump your head in it?
I would actually survive it and grow stronger and then devour you after. In the sequel, I'd actually beat you. So. Like okay. Gabe's the type of guy that wins in the first act.
Fuck.
Yeah, but I'm the guy who like overcome. I'm like the hero's journey, you know. So.
Bro watches Vinland Saga one time.
Yep, and now I'm stronger. Even though I'm weaker,
you're
I'm
stoic,
stronger.
I guess.
Some yeah, it's actually better to be weak. I mean,
any apprehension would be met with.
It's all over the mics. It breathe. You breathe into the mic follicles, yeah, and then totally. I use it later, and then I get an infection. So. Okay. Anyway. What do you say we whip out some old tweets?
Terrible tweets.
Terrible tweets. It's like the terrible twos.
Bing.
TerribleTweets.com. So yeah.
Everything used to have a fucking .com. Everything before like you followed some before people had like profiles of things, it was like go to Pacers.com or like fucking.
There's still .com.
Cool t-shirts.com. Well, everything
well, they
used
didn't
to,
say or .com
like,
as much.
Or like, no, like there used to be like, oh, meekmill.com. You yeah, know, like it wasn't like that's where you went and like bought the music and a little autobiography. Yeah, yeah. Now it's all like on Spotify.
Now
and also, you're a serial fucking killer if you have anything but Spotify. I mean, and SoundCloud. You have Apple Music, bro.
No, I don't. I have Spotify.
Okay, thank God. Because I was about to be pissed. Yeah, you just wanted to argue with me right there. I think that's what it was.
Yeah, I think so.
Bro, the fucking UI, actually, the user interface on Apple is terrible.
It's gross. It's disgusting.
It doesn't...
You have the giant, like... You can only see four album covers at a time.
Exactly. And like, also, it doesn't make playlists for you. And like recommend these new things.
There's no discoverability. No curation. For new artists.
No. I had it for like 2 months and I was like, this is awful.
I used to have it pretty bad. But
yeah. How about you start off with a tweet? We went through our old Twitters and we just found like the most unbearable tweets.
So
okay. I didn't even go through all of mine.
Before I get into the tweets, I screenshotted this comment on the Bermuda Triangle.
Okay.
The Eels video. Someone said, you do know the human body puts out energy and all kinds of shit, right? And then the guy responded, I lost 100 pounds and you want to talk to me about human body energy? Okay, buddy.
Yo. Was that even the original poster?
I guess these guys were in an argument, but it's not showing me the full. But that's just like in the middle of their argument.
I lost 100 pounds and you're going to tell me about human energy. Okay.
I know more about energy than you do.
That's funny as hell. I love whenever people get like into personal beefs in just our comments for some reason. Like this is
There's a lot of war ground.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Okay. So I think this was like 2018. So there was a trend going on at the time, I guess. It's like, honestly, rate yourself. And it's like looks, creativity, mental health. Like, and I had
2018. This is when we first.
Yeah, this is like Twitter
rekindled
era. So this is looks 6.5 out of 10. Creativity 6.5 out of 10.
I don't know what creativity I was basing on this is way higher.
I guess than I was just looks. Trying to be. I'm kidding. You're way more creative than you are handsome.
So
I don't know what I was basing this. Mental health 6 out of 10.
Bro, are you the most well-rounded individual?
I don't know. Like, mental health or empathy 8.5.
Well, that's true.
Empath.
Yeah.
Humor, I gave 9 out of 10. You know, whatever.
Humor 9 out of 10. Yeah. Well, maybe.
Patience 7 out of 10. Social skills 4 out of 10. I guess so.
Yikes! Yeah.
That's gross.
You were pretty.
What would you?
Rippling. Would I rate you?
Yeah. Or what would you rate yourself for these? What's your looks?
Looks.
What would you rate yourself on a scale of 1 to 10?
I'd say like 6.9. Anywhere from 6.5 to 6.9. I'd say that. I'd say like confidence is mostly what it is.
So you got the 8 going for you. Somewhere in the 8 range.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
It's pretty nice. If I didn't have the face that my mom gave me, I'd be screwed.
Well, you got the face, the height, the confidence, and the
beautiful eyes.
So I think that's like really.
And I have like really long chest hair. So
that's where the 0.9 comes in. So it's like,
yeah,
0.9.
Yeah. And then my creativity.
Creativity.
In conversations, I think my creativity is like a 9.
Yeah. Yeah.
But like if you sit me down, like if you sit me down in front painting. Of like a piece of paper, no, I'm
yeah,
not.
Yeah.
I'll different. Draw a tree. So
and what we got? Mental health.
No.
4.
Three. Yeah. 3 range. Solid 3. Solid 3. Yeah.
Empathy.
I'm pretty empathetic.
Yeah.
Not at first. Well, I don't know. Sometimes I know the vibe. I'm good at reading vibes.
Vibes of empathy.
Yeah, no. If it's vibes of empathy, I like. Okay. Do I feel is empathy like feeling bad?
It's like being able to put yourself in other shoes. So like you. So from an empath, from actually a level 26.
I think
empath,
that you should rate me on that because I don't.
I say you're like. In the 7 to 8.
Okay, nice. That's pretty good. So I think of others before I speak.
Yeah, yeah. That's like just compassion or
just human kindness.
I guess so.
I think that's bottom of the barrel is what you should be doing.
So say like Okay, say I'm like just somebody walking, a stranger,
mm-hmm.
and then you're walking by me. See if you can like empath what I'm feeling. So right now I'm feeling things. So see if you can like pick up what I'm feeling.
You just watched the 1993 Ninja Mutant Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie, and you were sad but scared how you felt whenever you saw Master Splinter die, because you felt bad. You saw his side of the story, because he was really just an evil exterminator who was just trying to do his job.
No, I actually shit my pants and I have Krentis.
Oh.
So that's what that
okay.
was.
Okay, well.
It was close.
Yeah.
So that's probably like a 7.
Well, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles definitely have Krentis. Like.
So, yeah. Krentis is not a real disease, so. But.
No, Krentis next. Isn't a real disease.
Next.
I've been saying that shit all week, though.
Me too. Humor, yeah, like 9, 10.
Ah, 10.
Let's give it like. Yeah, I was probably.
Yeah,
was
just give like, me a 10, the height, whatever. Just. Dunk,
dink. And then patience.
Ah.
That's like
zilch.
Like
zilch. No, not even
social
five.
Skills.
I think that my funny. I think I did ask my patients like a 2-1.
Yeah. So. Makes sense.
Social skills 10.
Yeah.
That's I'm the most social being that I yeah, feel like I'm the know. Most social being that I know.
I think so too.
So
very social.
That's yeah, I mean that's
I think I'd re-rate myself.
No, let me rate you.
Okay.
What does it looks?
Looks
7.5.
Yeah,
that's pretty easy. Good. Easy 7.5.
I think
too.
I can. I think that like you.
I would say easy 7.5, and then with some outfits 8.
Depends on if I got the clogs or.
Yeah, it depends if you wear your whittled shoes.
Yeah.
So.
My loafers or what have you.
Yeah, and your, what are those called? Slofenhongs.
Slofenheimers. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
It's close, yeah. You almost get it. Creativity
9.
Yeah, I don't know why I put. I feel like even
I don't know
then,
what
should have put.
Yeah, what the hell is like that?
7 or 8.
Yeah.
Know. Yeah. Empathy.
Empathy 10.
Yeah.
Empathy 10. Like
I guess I was like looking at other people. That
this
I
is
knew
the guy. This is
like,
the guy that you call.
Yeah.
Whenever I'll you feel, whenever you're going through it, because
yeah.
you'll automatically put him through it.
So, yeah, because I like.
Well, that's
feel
what
all
I do.
It.
Is out. You let
dude, that
him,
sucks.
He okay, so this is the setup. In his basement, he has a sensory deprivation tank that he floats right, in the right. water in darkness in. But you have to, he also has like a big iPad on it, but it's like, it's made with that sand, like magic sand. And you get a stylus yeah, on the yeah. outside and you write in like what you're going through. And it also, it shows up on his screen and he feels the emotions that you felt
yeah, yeah.
with them through the magic sand.
Physical, sexual, like.
Yeah, emotional. He comes in there.
Yeah, well, like, I personally, I'm the only one who really should be going in there, but.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So but yeah, it's not free. So
oh,
it's
no.
therapy.
Yeah, it's like a holistic therapy session. But like,
he
just
moves
like,
around.
I don't have any like thing to tell you. I just feel your feelings.
No,
like,
he
dude,
feels it.
Like,
and then
that's pretty rough, man.
He'll crawl out and be like, throwing up.
I mean, I'm sorry she ghosted you, bro. I don't know. That's it. That's
never said
I
was
say.
A therapist. I just feel the pain.
I'm just
a masochist.
Like, yeah, I don't like have anything to tell you, or I can't prescribe you anything.
That sucks.
That sucks. And then I go back in. Like, but it feels good. Like I love feeling people's pain. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, you're like, leave the door unlocked. I've got another session in 10. Close the.
And I'm like, I'm like butt naked, bloody. Like
have you have so many nosebleeds in there. Like, okay, what's the next?
Okay. I skipped mental health. That's probably like a 6.
Oh, your mental health. Well, it's gotten severely better.
Oh yeah, I used to be.
Yeah, no. So I would say that your mental health has to be 6.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I think maybe it's 7.
Therapy. I would say so. I would say 7.
Therapy yeah, works, guys. I'm actually evidence that therapy works.
Don't sometimes. Tell our users that.
Yeah, they won't listen therapists. To us anymore. Yeah, if there was like a world or if therapy became free and accessible to everybody and everyone like became normal to use it, we'd have like 3 listeners, I think.
Oh, easy.
Because, you know.
Yeah, because you guys are so
we
mentally
pray,
ill.
We pray
fucks.
On the mentally
yeah,
ill.
Yeah, what?
humor.
We flock as one, though. The voices of the broken.
Meme rating.
Your meme rating?
Yeah, meme rating.
What's next? What's on there?
Meme rating. Patience.
That's not your meme rating. It's patience.
Humor, patience.
Patience. You'll put up with things really long, so 10.
Yeah, I guess.
This guy will wait in a waiting room until the place closes. Yeah. So, until they call his name question it. They'll be like, oh, wait, what's your name? And like, oh, we didn't even write you on the list. You'll have to come back tomorrow morning.
Okay. Can I just wait here?
Oh, okay. And then what's the last one? Strength?
Yeah. Dexterity.
Dexterity. 3.
Social.
Social?
Like it's not good. Not very good.
No.
It's not bad.
I would say 6.5 to 7.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, yeah.
But you're better with like.
I know social.
You're better with me.
Yeah, I think so too.
So.
If I'm like comfortable. If I can just, have somebody I can like butt on.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Then that's good.
Because you're the commenter. You're the,
yeah, I'm like, I add like little.
You'll add the killer touch to it.
Like once per hour. Like the words per minute is really low.
Yeah.
Okay. That was a long. You have a tweet sliding?
Yeah, hell yeah. Okay, so. My tweet like from 8/4/21. I'm literally a registered flex offender. And then I put a baby emoji. A baby bottle
baby
emoji.
Bottle. One re. Retweet, one like?
One retweet, one like.
No data on that? It's like
Zoch.
Elon Musk.
Yeah, Elon Musk did it.
Mine's really bad. This was, January
25th, 2016.
Okay. I'd rather chill alone than try to fit in. Popular loner alert.
Hated but known. Popular loner.
8:01 a.m.
Jesus.
Right when class starts, I tweeted
that. You tweeted that by yourself leaning on your locker.
First day after
leaning on your locker.
Christmas break just ended.
That's sad, David.
Oh, no. Well, let me paint you guys a little picture. When I went to a new school in 2016, I hadn't jerked off in 6 months. I swore off ejaculation. Swore off porn. I was at a new school I'd never met. I had been the same school for 16 years, 15 years. Yeah. So I was horny as fuck.
That's
lonely
a high
as
test.
Lonely.
High test tech.
Low 4.10 at social skill. And yeah, just in a new environment.
So much testosterone. Red pilled out, bro. Yeah, you were red pilled.
Testosterone to my head. And
Jesus.
With no social skills to back it up.
Bro, no. It was 8:01 a.m. So you had just sat down
the bell
for your
rung.
First class.
Yeah.
And no one decided to sit next to you. And then you whipped out your phone and you tweeted that bullshit.
There's like a very common theme of like that in my tweets in that year.
Fuck.
It's bad.
That's hilarious.
Oh my God.
That's actually so funny.
Can I read my next retweet?
Yeah.
This is shortly after. This is February 2nd, 2016.
Okay.
Bryce retweet from Bryson Tiller.
No.
I just want real friends.
Bro, oh Gabe, bro had jacked off at that point.
That's when I let it loose after that. And it hit the ceiling.
Bro, that's a retweet that you had just nutted a gallon after.
Like, I just want real
you get
friends.
On Twitter and you're,
I'm tired of like fake friends, you know? Oh my God.
Bryson Tiller was tweeting bullshit back then.
That guy. Holy shit.
Okay.
Hit me.
Mine was 7/18/21. Normalize calling the aquarium the liquid zoo.
That's a good tweet. That is a good
three
tweet.
Likes, one retweet.
That is,
underrated tweet.
That's an underrated tweet for sure.
The liquid zoo. That's pretty good.
I don't know why.
I thought I snapped on that.
Yeah. Okay. This is February 19th. So this like a couple weeks after Bryson Tiller.
This is just a journey on like a,
I know, yeah, it's like
a slideshow of
my testosterone
were.
Journey. Yeah. So there are some people that really put my fake laugh to the test.
You tweeted that? Oh my
dude, I had
God,
16 and I had no
bag.
I had no social like anything.
What did you just want to be the edge lord at your high school?
Oh my God, I guess so, yeah.
Jesus.
I wasn't actually like how my tweets depict, but
God.
Maybe internally that's how I felt.
I guess so. This one is from 9/29/2018, and I tweeted at J.R. Smith, NBA champion.
Oh God. Your replies are
freshly NBA champion.
Yeah.
Also. And he was just off the Henny on Twitter celebrating. Yeah, yeah. I said, "Is Kyle Korver your biological father?" And then he
I think I remember this.
Quote tweeted this and said, "Is yours the mailman?"
I do remember this. Yeah, you got pwned by J.R. Smith.
I got pwned by J.R. Smith.
I remember that. Why is like being the mailman that bad?
I don't know.
Oh, you probably deliver my mail, little bro.
Your daddy That's delivers so your mail.
I remember when that happened and you were like, dude, J.R. Smith just said my dad's a mailman.
Like, classic.
So this was a retweet from somebody that we knew. He went to he tweeted, "I have no respect for dudes that disrespect females because they want to seem cool to the people they hang around." And I was like, I'll retweet that.
Retweet.
And then I'm like hoping that like people see it and like, yeah, I respect women. You know?
Hoping that a girl was
Facts.
On your Twitter.
Yeah. Just creating.
Okay, he respects men, check. Oh. He respects women, check.
And I guess he needs some real friends. I don't know.
I want to fuck this guy. Yeah,
that'll do it.
That's what you're going for. This one says, yeah, shout out Carl Azus, man.
Who's that?
And I had to Google who Carl Azus was. And Carl Azus is the host of a CNN morning news show for high school kids. And it was just like, it's just like some 10-minute like segment. And it's like, oh, here's a funny clip of what happened at a zoo in North Carolina. And then at the end of the show, it's like, shout out Mount Perrin Christian, like okay. The school of the week.
And then
but the guy was really good at his job.
Okay.
He's fire. Like, I need to go watch some more. But yeah.
He's actually in prison now though.
I said shout out Carl Azus, and then I looked it up. I looked up his name and like I think this is why I tweeted it, because I heard that he died.
Oh.
And
it's okay. Worse than prison.
And then it like the first Google review was like, Carl Azus is still alive and happily dedicated to his job.
Like, oh,
it's like
dead.
A Twitter meme.
Yeah,
that
it's
he
like
died.
He didn't die, guys. Yeah. Shout out, Carl.
Yeah.
So we're looking at April 1st, 2016.
Okay.
So a couple more weeks. It's April 1st, and you know what that means. The first day of White History Month. Make sure you thank a white person today for everything. two likes on that guy.
Jesus.
Probably not the best tweet to make during the rise of the Black Lives Matter movement.
No, probably not, so, David.
Probably not on that one. So
Jesus.
Somebody replied and deleted it.
Yeah, because they supported it.
And they
and
went
then back
I said, haha, thanks, but I don't know what they said.
Yeah, no. Oh my God. My next one was 5/19/21, white people don't have culture. Explain grandma nicknames then.
True.
But not true at all, because I realized
that we just take it from other cultures.
From other cultures.
Any like grandma name is just from, you know.
And this girl responded to my tweet, by the way.
Epic.
If you don't leave my Mima and Mimi out of this.
Yeah. Mimi, Momo, Pipi, Papa, and Gigi,
and Poopoo.
Yeah, you guys, your Twitter's way better than mine. Mine's just disgusting.
Yours is just horny.
Well, this is actually this is a banger tweet.
Okay.
So, 4 retweets, 8 likes. If you're in a relationship and have held hands before marriage, well, I hope you continue to hold hands in hell. Peak Christian school
that
humor.
Needs to be on a t-shirt.
Yeah. It's like with like really epic shit. Like with fire and
yeah,
like
text and it's like fire and ice like fighting.
Oh God,
that's good. 4 likes.
Yeah. 4 retweets, 8 likes.
Four retweets, 8 likes.
Yeah,
Damn. Reach.
Yeah, I don't know if you were one of them, but
probably.
Probably three of them.
This one said, I asked my friend his opinion on Publix employees, and his response was, ugh, just join the military already.
What? That is a Publix response.
I don't know if that was you. I don't know if you were my friend. 2020.
Well, if we were friends.
We were friends. This could have been you coming from you.
Are you just going to join the military or what?
Just join the military already. That's pretty good. 5 likes.
Okay, this is like probably the worst. I don't even know if I can say this. But this is we're looking at 12, 8, 16. Mm-hmm. My girl Amber just gave me her dress, about to come over, and it's an Amber alert. So.
You can say that.
It's just a bad joke.
It's just a bad joke.
You can't say that. It's just not funny. There's no laws against saying that.
No, you could say that all day. But there is
also no laws for me not laughing. Yeah. So.
Don't expect a
good outcome.
I
thought I was so clever. 6 likes.
No, because it's good. It's good. 6 likes. I feel like if I read it in my on my own time on Twitter, I'd be like, oh.
You'd like do a little.
Yeah.
Like a. Yeah. And then you'd get, you'd then be the 7th. You'd be the 7th.
Like, yeah. This dude's going somewhere.
Wait, this is actually, I actually really like this tweet still. So this is a, this was my senior year of high school. Don't you hate it when you're talking to a nice 60-year-old man online and then it turns out to be a 16-year-old girl shaking my head? Well, I was 16, so, or 7.
Read
it
again.
I was 17.
Don't you hate whenever you're talking to a 60-year-old man online and it turns out to be a 16-year-old girl?
Just a little.
It's just a little reverses. Humor, yeah. SMH.
Got duped again by another hot 16-year-old girl while also being 16.
In another dimension. In another dimension, yeah. That's how that goes.
In the Rick and Morty verse. Are you done? Are you?
I'm done.
You done? Okay. Let me just rapid fire. The moon is flat. Well, Gabe actually tweeted, and I retweeted, why would anyone drink or do drugs? I get high off respecting women. That was pretty, banger. Yeah.
When?
This was 9/25/17. September 2017. Yeah. And then I tweeted shortly after you said that, actually 2 days after that, I said to my future son, if you're reading this, the divorce is all your fault. Disney World and Universal, no thanks. I'll be having my vacation at Planet Drool.
Yes, facts.
And that's about it. and I'm actually deleting my Twitter after this.
Yeah. No, I'm going to have to re-go because all my tweets were from 2 years ago. So I need to deep dive on that.
The Facebook, I actually spent like 3 days. One day, like deleting on my old Facebook
I've scrubbed my Twitter before.
It's bad. So many like for TBH or whatever. You know. So many. Well, I thought
so many broke my scales.
I didn't know like nudes were an issue. Just my on prepubescent. Yeah.
Yeah. Facts.
I thought that's what it was for. I don't know. Okay, guys. Would you have a quick? You had a quick.
I have a little
work
quick
story,
work story,
and then we'll get into. I have some stories.
So. Basically,
work story.
Work story. I get sat around the fire pit at my job, and I'm the only person on this gazebo, and it was a party of 20 that came in.
Yeah,
and I was by myself completely, and everything that went wrong, everything that could have went wrong went wrong.
Yeah,
but not the power didn't go out or anything, but it was more of like. User error on my part.
Yeah.
And basically like
your power went out.
The checks, I had them in order at one point, and then something happened, and all 60 plus of the items that they ordered of a group of 20, 15 like adults and like 5 children. Everything got put onto one ticket instead, and I was like, "Oh, I need to make like 6 checks and I have no idea which goes on each one.
Yeah. Oh God. So, so you'd have to go and ask them.
I had to go. I had to. Oh, bro, 20. Bro, I had to print out this long, the entire itemized receipt, and I had to be like, okay, who's paying? And then I had to go and had to be like, okay, so you got. Well, tell me what you got, and then I would mark like a one next to everything that went on the first ticket, to everything that went on the second ticket. I went over to the POS to mark it all in. And I had almost everything. I was looking at that POS. They had been waiting to check out for 30 minutes at this point.
Yeah.
Ready to pay and leave. 30 minutes.
One star.
I made one mistake and I wiped all the tickets. And I had to restart. Oh. And I grabbed the side of the computer like this and was squeezing the side of the computer. And
it turned off.
And my feet were like, I was standing there and my toes curled up and so hard in my work shoes that the sole that was attached to the bottom came off the front parts. God. I was so angry.
Yeah.
Then this beautiful angel named Blake.
Yeah.
He's listened to the show before.
Okay.
He's the most handsome guy that works there. And I was flailing. I was asking people who were going by for help. And he was the only one who stopped. And I was like, bro,
good Samaritan.
I'm going to kill myself. I really, really need your help right now. Like, desperately. And he was like, oh, okay. Yeah. He had like tables and stuff.
He's holding like souffle in
like,
each hand.
Has like a fucking, like the like tray the, yeah, on his head.
Yeah, and he's like balancing
all the cups
it, like,
are like stacked. Whoop. Yeah, like up. And he's just like. And he was like, oh, it's cool, man. Just tell me what you need. And just doing it all. And then eventually my server manager, who's a god, he came over and he was like, okay, but like, you just go back to your tables. I'll help Gabe. And then he just stood there. It's like your big brother whenever you can't like play a video game. He walked in. He was like, he looked at me. He said, calm down. You're okay. And I was like.
Caressing you.
I like almost like went on his shoulder and cried. And he saved me out of it, but it did take them over an hour to check out.
Well, they had to be pissed. Like
they were nice. They took it really well.
This was your manager?
No, that was my manager and Blake.
Yeah.
Shout out them. My favorite meme. Shout out them. The realest dudes I've ever met in my entire life. So many people were like, "I'm too busy. Yeah, I got to do my
own thing."
A
good Samaritan.
And it's like, I guess that's fine, man.
Yeah.
Still grabbing. Oh, and every time like we had to edit something on the computer, like Blake, like and we did like we finalized something, the computer would shut off and restart. It took like 5 seconds, like, and then I would have to re-swipe my card and let him back in and do everything. It was terrible.
Like when you were looking around like for help and you saw Blake, and then you like it became slow motion as you turn around and he's like, I need a hero to save me.
Yes.
Not gonna do it. And then you block eyes.
And I was like.
And he's like,
He trained me at the beginning. I love him so much. And I would do anything for him.
Yeah.
Just so you know. Like, sweet angel Blake. Anything.
Anything. Yeah, shout out Blake. Okay. So I got a couple videos to show you, man.
Okay.
First, so this is like the new Andrew Tate. So,
okay. I'm sure I'm familiar with him.
So this guy, so that's another tipping.
Okay.
You know?
A tipping thing?
Yeah.
Tipping in America is crazy. I went to a Starbucks recently and I ordered a croissant. Mm-hmm. And then the barista spun the machine around. It said, do you want a tip? And then I asked her, I said, do people normally tip here? At Starbucks. And she said to me, yeah, people tip if they want to be nice.
If they want to be nice?
And then she said it with a voice where it was sort of an attitude. Mm-hmm. And then I said, okay, well, if I tip, do I get a blowjob?
You said that?
And for how long?
And for how long?
Long story short, she actually called the cops. As they arrested me, they pushed me away. I remember thinking that I would have actually tipped her if she wasn't such a bitch. You know, and that's actually Alpha King rule number 14. You can attract way more bees with honey.
Bees with honey. Beehive. Yeah.
Wait, this isn't serious.
No, it's a joke. It's a joke.
Okay, thank God.
I want to see because what you think.
It was funny as hell because that was really funny if it wasn't serious.
So people are thinking people it's think real it's right serious. Now, yeah.
That's actually Alpha King Rule 14.
It's actually you're going to attract more bees no,
that's
with
funny
honey
as hell.
Than a beehive. So. They had another one too.
They did that really. They did.
It looks
they're
like
good.
A real
yeah,
alpha
they're good at doing
whatever.
This. Yeah.
Ago, I went over to a friend's house for a small get together. I took a couple girls with me. Well, it was obvious that one of the girls that was gorgeous, she had her eyes set on my friend, the host.
Classic.
I knew I didn't have a chance, so I had to get creative fast. I excused myself from the dinner party. I went to the bathroom and I shit on the toilet seat. Then I rejoined everybody back at the dinner table. And I asked my friend, hey, why do you have shit on your toilet seat? He tried to deny it, but none of us believed him. I ended up taking that girl home that night. Remember, Alpha King rule number 18. When you're losing, exactly. Creativity is your best friend.
Yeah.
Yo, he's actually spitting.
Sign up to my newsletter.
At the end of every video. No, he so spits good. Hard, actually. Yeah.
But he looks like a guy that would
no, he
be
looks,
like
he looks
this.
Like Andrew Tate.
Yeah. He's the new, it's like the.
I fuck with that guy.
The new, I don't know, I feel like every time an Andrew Tate dies, just like a new
there's
one.
There's a new
just,
one that comes. Yeah, no, I've seen emerges. So many and it's just so awkward. Yeah, whenever they're being dead ass about it, it's like.
Oh God.
The only person who can really do that is Andrew Tate because he's actually fi at it.
Yeah, it's like.
So, let me see. I have. A video for you.
Okay.
I think.
Oh, God. Every Matt Rife.
So this is a Matt Rife.
Yeah, I've seen this, I think.
Have you seen this one?
No.
Oh, I don't know. I've seen a lot. There's like a lot of.
Okay.
Like,
well, this one is the only one I've seen.
No.
Oh, God.
Sips of water.
Dude, I love your outfit, man. What's your name?
Winston.
No, it's not. Bro, this dude about to be a British monarch. Yeah. What do you do?
I'm a sex worker.
I was not expecting that. are these like your sexual partners?
No, I'm gay.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
No.
Like this is happening.
Oh shit. Bro. You made it to the sleepover, bro. You made
like,
it to the sleepover.
So Matt Rife though.
Yo, I actually think like I'm gay. Nah.
the third strap after.
I love the like,
dude. He had his impressions spot on. Yeah. Like all of the down Wait, to the T.
I want to see if I can Buddy. Find a video I saw like of the same like type of meme.
Matt Rife.
It's so good. Wait,
Matt Rife sucks. By the
you
way,
like,
I hate that guy.
You hate him?
Absolutely. He's not funny at all. Sorry. And I have a real video of Matt Rife to send you as well. Actually, just to show
oh, like
you how bad he sucks.
Oh, I actually,
from the podcast from.
From Bert Kreischer?
Yeah. Was it the one about gaslighting?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he said...
I had a really, really good girl. Like, everything was going so well at every step of the way. I really thought that, like, she was going to be the one. Like, I'm going to marry you. And then I messed up a little bit.
But her reaction to it was what really gave it away.
So
the reaction was way bigger.
The reaction made it so much bigger.
What is
and
what
I
does a little
it.
Bit mean?
Like, bro, you fucked like, someone.
I cheated on her and then she got all crazy.
I'm Matt Rife.
What do you expect? Yeah, I feel like he probably does suck, but I feel like it's one of those things like I think
his stand up is not funny.
I can watch like
I can't
I watch
his stand up now.
It. On TikTok?
No, I can't do that.
And I just like, but it's one of those things where like
his videos are like 10 minutes, bro.
It's like entertaining, but like I know it's like not like good.
I'm gonna have to call Caroline after this.
But she actually does not like Matt Rife.
Thank you. I know she wouldn't. I knew she wouldn't, bro.
I would go see him or like I like
him.
Yeah,
fucking right, bro.
Dude, if
you would go and see Matt Rife, no, because if we didn't have this conversation and he came to Atlanta. You
no,
would text me and
I'm
be like,
yo,
you know, Matt, and we were like bored. You know, be like, you know, Matt Rife is in here. It's like $27 tickets. And then I would say, no, bro, what the fuck are you talking about? And then you'd say, oh, well, I'll pay for your ticket.
Because you wouldn't go that bad, you'd pay double.
No, there's plenty of people I would love to see, and he's not okay in that conversation.
Who would you see? Who would you see first? Matt Rife, or let's see, somebody who sucks. Matt Rife or a Green Day concert?
Oh, God.
In 2023.
Okay, well, I don't even like. There's like artists I love that I don't even go see there because I just don't. I'd probably go see Matt Rife.
Okay, before. Well, you're a fucking coward and a puss because you know that the Green Day merch would be sick, and that'd be the only reason
that's true. Yeah.
Nope. The merch. Nope. I can't find the video. You can't join it now, because, I won't be getting you merch while I'm at the show either, because you'll be at Matt Rife.
No, I don't. I'm not a Matt Rife stan. I just can tolerate it. It's just like the same thing. Like, I'm watching a GTA 5 car under something. Like, it's the same thing. Like, I'm just like brain dead content.
I sent you one more video.
Yeah, I couldn't find the one I was gonna show. But he was like, "What's your name?" And it's like Sabrina. And he's like, "Sabrina, you a little teenage witch, huh, Sabrina?"
Oh
and
it's my like, god!
I hate
it. It's a mostly women like laugh to crowd sound bit, which is so funny to me.
The crowd, I don't know.
Like, crowd work. Is I love crowd work sometimes
when it's done right. But now it's just like you don't even plan comedy and you just talk to people now. It's like,
yeah, no.
I don't know.
What's your name?
Okay, I'll admit I watched Matt Rife's stand-up special.
Did whatever. You?
God.
Did you?
Last year. It was all right. It was okay. But I had it in the background. I was playing Zelda.
Nope.
So I just had like stand-up playing in the background.
You watched a stand-up this year?
No, it was back. No, I watched some of it.
This year.
I started it, David. But it wasn't good. It wasn't good.
No, it's not good because he's not good. He's not a comedian.
Yeah, no.
He's not
I just
funny.
Watched like, it's like trending.
I'm upset with you. I'm going to be honest. I'm pretty upset.
I'm
with
not
you.
A Matt. It's like a fan. I just watch. Okay. I watch a lot of comedy. Anyway. Okay, fine. I watched it three times.
I know. Okay. I'm kidding. I know you did.
I didn't.
You peed yourself laughing too.
I'm like, oh my god, that's so true. Women do be doing that.
Oh my god, women love my god, metal straws. So women love metal straws.
Oh, he's so good.
Oh, he's oh my so god, good.
So true. Fuck.
Fuck.
Okay, let's see this video again.
Shit, Matt.
My boy telling me, I messaged a girl. It has to be different from all the other guys. Okay.
And then for the listeners, he's sending a message, a video
like a
message.
Video message.
There are 3.97 billion men on Earth, but there is one
oh my
who's
God.
Different from all the other guys. A man who likes watching movies, eating snacks, and listening to music. He is a complex individual. He likes to chill out, but also likes to party. He exists completely on his own wave that many do not understand.
This would work,
a man
though.
A few words, but he has one thing to say.
What are you doing?
Boom. Hey.
Hey. That's so good.
But I was going to say we
so
need...
Wow, that was so different from all the other guys. This is a real conversation that I'm having with you. And not your second phone.
You need to help me make one of those.
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
We'd go crazy on that.
This is like... slightly rated, but I saw like a Nelk podcast clip and it was Kyle Steiny and Brad.
Wait, was this the electricity one?
No. Oh. That one's good funny, too. Yeah. But they were talking like
it's not electricity.
Kyle was talking like to Steiny about how he like tried to DM this like 7 million follower like Instagram model. And he's like, dude, what was your like your slide too? It was like, it was so bad. And he's like, he DM'd.
This is Steiny?
Yeah, or Steiny's Kyle's DMing. Talking, and he said that. Kyle said that about Steiny.
Oh.
And, like, so Steiny, like, took a screenshot of one of her songs, and it was, like, captioned, like, under it, like, yo, this, like, really got me through some dark times. And he said he unsent it. He's like, yo, I unsent it, though. That's the worst Riz ever. It's like if I like found some girl who like writes fan fiction, and I like sent a picture of it's like favorited on my Wattpad. I'm like, yo, like this for real, like has gotten me through like long nights.
Bro, I'm not even gonna lie to you.
Wait, you did that?
I've done that.
No. That's bad.
I didn't say that it got me through anything or anything like that, but I said that I like the song.
Okay. Well,
which is better than, and I didn't screenshot nothing.
You screenshot, but like.
I'm laughing partially at him and partially Spotify at myself raps. Because that's so funny.
Like, yo, you yo, made your number
got
two.
Me through some hard times.
What are you going through?
It's insane.
Some dark times is what he said.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that's
Steiny's so funny.
He's the worst guy.
Even if you were on the Joe Rogan Network podcast.
Imagine
Steiny,
Joe Rogan
not.
And Steiny.
If
who'd
Joe
tear
Rogan,
that guy to shreds?
Joe Rogan and Steiny were on a podcast together, dude. Steiny would be meat riding Joe so hard.
Yeah.
Everyone meat rides Joe Rogan so hard whenever they're on his podcast. Yeah. Oh,
even if they like talk shit about him, but like in their podcast,
because they know that they are getting the longest commercial they'll ever have in their
life.
It's
literally like people save it for the right time when they're like,
yeah, they're like, I don't want to go on Rogan right now. I don't have anything to.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well,
thanks for
I think we'll cut it here.
Joining in.
Yeah. So I actually have to get, finish Matt Reif's.
Yeah, he's got to get back to that.
I got a cold glass of rosé and...
And I will be
bathtub.
Applying his rose toy
yeah,
while he watches.
Licking my Twitter. Yeah, like... And all my tweets, if they got more than 5 likes, I...
It's a
under
sunset
it, I'm like,
lamp. Sunset
click
lamp,
the link
rose
for the
toy.
Rose. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think, like, dang, this one popped off. Maybe I could get
some
money
sales.
For this.
It's a Temu. It's a Temu fucking ad. All right.
Thank you guys for watching. Remember new episodes every Monday. Every Monday morning.
Every Monday morning or so.
Or so. Yeah. So like in the Monday morning vicinity in that range. Remember guys, the Discord is right here if you need it. We'll be helping you out with everything you need in there. And we'll see you guys next week.